Hello students, let us begin the class with a new topic children. So in the last class I have explained about what writing part children. After completion of the writing part we are going to deal with the study skills children. So study skills, if you refer the page number 97, all should open the textbook page number 97 children. So what is there children here? Note making students, note making. Note making students. So this type of bits will come in your essay exam. It is very important. It is very important to do the note making from whatever the passage or the paragraph given in the text or in the question paper. Okay children, let us see what is note making on and how we are going to do that bit. We take notes when we read a book in order to record information for future reference. What we are doing children, we are taking the notes when we read a book. When we are reading a book, we will note down some notes. We will take some notes when we read a book in order to record information for future reference. Whenever you want to refer in the future children, the book, directly you can open these notes and you can refer the information. If you are going through all the points, it may take lot of time. So if you refer the notes, that is very easy for the reference in your future. Such notes help us to revise lessons easily before examination. And for you children, for you it is very easy to refer for your examination, to revise the lessons for your examination. So what is your duty after the completion of the lesson? What you should do children? So you should have to note some points, note some point that should be kept as a side. When you are going to prepare for the examination children, when you are going to prepare for the examination, at that time it is very useful. The note making is very useful for revising for your examination. Let's know the process of note making. How should we make the note? How should we make the note? Let us see here children. Read the passage once quickly. What you should do? You should have to read the passage quickly. Suppose one passage is given in the examination, the less time is mentioned, the time is given less for in the examination. And what is your duty? Read the passage once quickly. Next point, what you should have to remember? Underline the key terms during the second reading. When you are reading, you should have to underline the key term, that means important point you should have to underline the key term during the second reading. See, first of all, what you are doing, you are reading the passage quickly, very soon you are reading. Then afterwards what you are doing, you are underlining the important points or the keywords for the second time. Next, note only the most important information. What you should have to do, you should have to note most important information only. You should have to underline, note only the most important information. Next, condense the information, get the meaning of that information. Next, omit examples and illustrations. You should have to give much more examples compared to that underlined part children. Next, organize the condensed information in a suitable format. Whatever you have noted now, you should have to do children? You should have to organize in a condensed information in a suitable form. Okay. Next, keep a suitable title. After noting down, you should have to keep the appropriate title which is suitable for that passage. Okay children, so these are the steps involved in writing note making. Okay children, now if you turn the page, what is given here? Some strategies for condensing information, means for reducing. Condensing is nothing but for reducing. Some strategies for condensing the information. Let us see what are those given children. First one, use numbers instead of words. Writing figures you might have learned in the primary section, I think, children. So instead of writing the words, you can mention the number. Suppose 68 given in the textbook, no? 58 you can write, no? FIFTY. 58 EIGHT. Instead of writing 58, you can write 582. Yes, you are condensing. Yes, you are condensing. So that one only he has given. The first point what he has given, use numbers instead of words. Example 68 written as 68. Use short substitute for long words. Okay, short substitute. Suppose our subject in textbook he has given mathematics children. MATHEMATICS. The full form of our maths. This is the short form. MATHEMATICS. This is the full form. This is the short. Okay, understood children. Instead of writing mathematics, maths, environmental studies, EBS you can write. EBS, environmental studies. Yes or no children? Yes. Now, use reduced verb form. Killed instead of was killed. Okay, was killed given the children in the textbook. Suppose was killed given means what you should have to write? You should have to write only killed. K-I-L-L-E-D. Killed instead of was killed. Now use the to infinitive to indicate future time. To infinitive. Example, what he has given? Relief team to help the people. Example, relief team. To infinitive, relief team. Instead of using the other words, we are using relief team. Relief teams to help the people. Use abbreviation. Next point, children. Use abbreviation and acronyms. Acronyms. IAF. He has given full form, children, in the textbook. IAF. What is the full form of IAF, children? If you refer the lesson, in the lesson he has given IAF, Indian Air Force. What is this, children? Indian Air Force. IAF. Next, again, AIR. What is the abbreviation of the AIR? All India Radio. So this short forms you should have to use. Use abbreviations and acronyms. These are the abbreviations. Next, use condensed spellings of words. Condensed spellings of words for department. Okay. DEPT. Yes, it's given here. DEPT. Instead of using department. In spite of using the department, DEPT, doctor, instead of writing full spelling, D-O-C-T-O-R, doctor, what we are writing? D-R. Yes, children, what we are writing? We are writing here, D-R, that means doctor. Yes, doctor. Department, D-E-P-T for department, D-R for what? For doctor. Okay, children, these are the strategies for condensing the information. In which we are using this one all, children? We are using in the note making. We are using what? In note making, we all are using this one. Here is a model answer for paragraph 2 to 5 from your reading passage. Passage A. From the passage A, children, we have passage A and passage B again. Yes? From the passage A, okay. Here is a model answer for paragraph 2 and 5. In the paragraph 2 and 5, he has given. See here, children, what he has given? Heading, floods in Kurnool. So, he has written the date. First point, what the date? 28-9-2009, he has given, children. That means, what had happened in the 28th day, 28-9-2009, what had happened, children? A. No tourist people has arrived to the Kurnool district. Next one. B. No buses have arrived to the place. Due to what, children? Due to the floods. Next, 27-9-2009. If you refer the textbook. Okay, 2 to 5 paragraph, from the paragraph 2nd, 3rd and 4th fifth, second, third, fourth and fifth paragraph. This all you will find in the on the date of this. What has happened? No tourist has arrived. No tourist. Just we are making the note, children. Note making. Okay, from the paragraph. It is a very big paragraph. Suppose 5 lines, 10 lines it may be. From those lines, you just note the point. On 28th, 9, 2009, what had happened? A and B or 3, C, D. If you have found 3 or 4 important information, you can note. So, next one. In 2008, what had happened? No tourists has came and there were no buses have arrived to that place. On 27, what had happened, children? Heavy rainfall on the evening, after the evening, when all the people have went away to their homes. From the evening, total line, there was a full rainfall. That means heavy rainfall. B, children, dam, cold and cloudy climate. Dam and cold and cloudy climate, they have occurred. Next one. Pouring rain, all the clouds are pouring, the total nights were pouring the rain. We have seen this sentence in the what, children? In the fifth paragraph, I think so. Okay, in the textbook, we have found. Next one, children. Third one, 28-9-2009. Again, comes to 28-9-2009. What had happened? Third note point. River water entered the streets. River water enter not only streets, you can mention river water has filled with the river water is filled all over the huts also, okay, houses also. Next, flood inundating houses. Flood inundating, there is no finding of house. The houses were totally covered with the immersed with the water. Next, 20 lakh Q6 inflow to the Srisailam dam. Okay, 20 lakh Q6 of Inflow was there in the which dam, children? Srisailam dam. Next, threat of flood on the banks of the river. There is a threat of floods on the banks of the rivers. Okay, bank of the river. Which river, children? Krishna. Threat of flood on the banks of the river Krishna. Next one, E. Heartrending senses. It was a very heartrending senses. Scenes. S-C-E-N-E-S. Scenes. Scenes means something but, children, whatever the situation is going on, for that we are going to tell, describing about the, we are telling that it was a scene. So, it was heartrending. It is a very sorrowful scene. Next, people seeking help to rescue them. People are what doing here? People seeking help. Means they are in need of help to rescue them. Okay, children, these are the note points taken from the second, third, fourth and fifth paragraph. So this is the note making. We have noted the 3 points. From the 3 points, main information we have collected. Yes, children. Now our duty, what is our duty? He has given in passage. Let us do, children. Now make note from the following passage and then summarize it. I am going to read the passage. Page number 99, children. Okay, page number 99. Let us see here. I should keep the concentration in the textbook itself. See here. The word disaster. The word disaster is derived from Middle French. From which country, children? From Middle French. They have derived this word. Disaster. Disaster. Disastre. That means it is derived from the Middle French disastre. And from Old Latin. And from the Old Latin, is also known as the disastro. Disastro. What, children? Now, a disaster can be defined as any tragic event that can cause damage to life, property and destroy the economic, social and cultural life. Okay, children, just I will read. Okay, after that we should have to note, we should have to follow the points what he has given while making the note. Okay, children. The natural disaster is a consequence when a natural hazard affects human or built environment. Human vulnerability, the human vulnerability and lack of appropriate emergency management leads to the financial, environmental and human loss. The resulting loss depends on the capacity of the population to support or resist the disaster. Disasters occur when hazards meet vulnerability. Okay, children. A natural hazard will never result in a natural disaster in areas without vulnerability. Various phenomena like earthquake, landslide, volcanic eruption, floods, and cyclones are all natural hazards, or we can tell natural disasters also. That kills thousands of people and destroy a lot of money and property each year. Next paragraph, children. Last one. Natural hazards can strike in unpopulated areas and never develop into disaster. The rapid growth of the world's population and its increased concentration often in hazardous environment has escalated both the frequency and severity, severity of natural disasters. So tropical climate, unstable landform, deforestation and non-engineered construction make the disaster prone areas more vulnerable. Developing countries suffer more or less chronically by natural disaster. Okay, children, I have read the passage. Now, note pointing. We should have to note the main important information from this passage. Let us see. First one I will do here. First point you can make. See here. First point. What is that, children? First one. First point. You can write disaster origin. Disaster origin. That means the word disaster has come from where? Okay, the word disaster came from where? So it is derived from. Okay, disaster is derived from Middle French. No need of writing a full paragraph, children. No need of writing a full sentence. What you should write? Okay, you should keep the note making this point as a note making. Disaster origin. Down you can keep the point or A or B, anything. Middle French disaster and from. Okay, disaster, old Latin disastro. That is enough. Okay, that means you have noted one point. It has derived from the Middle French disaster and from old Latin disastro. That is enough. You have made one note making is completed, children. Now goes to the second one. Meaning. Disaster meaning, children. This is the second note point. What is the meaning? Disaster can be defined. Okay, defined as a, it is meaning. It is a tragic event. So, need of writing disaster can be defined as any tragic. No need. It is a tragic event that can cause damage to life, property, and destroy the economic, social, and cultural life. That is enough. Okay, this one is enough to write in the second note point, children. Meaning. You should have to write the meaning. Now comes to what's done here? Natural disaster or hazard. Okay, natural. Third note point. Natural disaster. Natural disaster or hazard. H-A-Z-A-R-D. Yes, hazards. Okay, children. How it is called? Okay, various phenomena like what are the natural disasters, what are those, children? So if you refer the page number, if you refer the third paragraph, okay, what are those? Earthquake, landslide, volcanic eruption, floods and cyclone. Okay, cyclone, this all comes under natural disasters or hazards, children. These are, so you have pointed with the third point, you have noted the third note point also. What are those? Natural disasters or hazards. Okay, children. Now, disaster. Okay, now suppose directly we are noting the point. Fourth point, disaster. What is a disaster? Disaster. Okay, children. Disaster. What can you tell children about disaster? Human vulnerability and lack of appropriate emergency management. So, How it is caused? How the disaster is caused? Due to the human vulnerability. Second paragraph, second line if you see. Human vulnerability and lack of appropriate emergency management leads to financial, environmental and human loss, children. So this will become what? This will become the disaster note point. Now fifth one, children. Fifth one, what one? Reason. What is the reason for the occurrence of the disaster? What is the reason for the occurrence occurrence of disaster. What is the reason, children? If you tell tropical climate, last paragraph, third line, children, tropical climate, unstable landform, deforestation and non-engineered construction make the disaster. These are the reasons. Okay, what are the reasons for the occurrence of the disaster, children? Disasters are due to the tropical climate, unstable landforms, deforestation and non-engineered constructions. These are the reasons for the disaster. So what, children, from the passage, first, second, third, fourth and fifth, five note points we have taken. So we have wrote the reason also. Okay, children, this is the bits which you are going to face in the essay examination. In the model paper, you are going to come across this type of question. So be careful while reading the passage. Then you should have to note the points. In the same way, if you follow for our lessons, it will be easy to remember the lessons from your textbook, children. So with this, I am ending my class. In the next class, we will be meeting with another topic.